वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमित श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नितानंदसहोदित श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदय गोपीजन समयुक्त बिंदवन मनोहर वाछाकूश कृपा सिंधुव्यवच पति पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवभ्यो नमो नम मूकंकोतिचा लंगुं लंघयतगिरी यमहंग वंदे परमानंदमाधव बृंदावै तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशव कृष्णभक्तिपदे देवी सत्वत्वी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीर संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरीयपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्ति युक्तो भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण्य धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नम् अभीष्टदूहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरिञ्चिनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतात्तिहम् पनुतपाल्यभवद्विपूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनिच्चटाय विस्फुरजीत किमपि गोवधू स्वदर्श पूर्णानुरागरस सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदी गौरभक्तबिंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदी गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकाबुदातु संकीर्तनैकवितरो कमलायुथाक्षौ विश्वाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ युगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणाम्बुतारौ हरे कृष्ण कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानां गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरी निरंतरविभूषी त्वां भागम् नारायणो प्रियमनंगमदाफहारं वरानसिकुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशजिश्वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदये संवित् त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम। रुद्रस्य सुखं किञ्चिन्न सुखं चक्रवर्तिनः सुखमस्ति विरक्तस्य मुनिरेकान्तजीवनम् न च इन्द्रस्य सुखं किञ्चिन्न सुखं चक्रवर्तिनः सुखमस्ति विरक्तस्य मुनिरेकान्तजीवनम् गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड दैट विथ ए मूड टू गेट कंट्रोल ओवर दिस मेटेरियल वर्ल्ड इफ यू आर गोइंग टू सी दिस जगत देन इट बिकम अ टाइट बॉन्डेज फॉर अस गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru told, with a mood to get control over this material world, if I look this material world, this darshan become a tight bondage for us, very tight bondage for us. When I am going to think myself superior to you, then the question coming that I can insult you, I can humiliate you, I can underestimate you. Baba saying, if I think myself superior to you, then at all the question of humiliating others, insulting others, to look, is coming. Otherwise not. In Chaitanya Mahat one day, Prabhupada shouting and speaking, because some so-called so-bottle, you know, in different shop, medicine shop, different Ayurvedic shop, there is so bottle. So bottle means there is nothing, only advertisement. Prabhupada's Kesava Goswami used to say, in Chaitanya Mahat, in Gauriya Mahat, sometime we find some so bottle. They think themselves very important. They don't care anybody. They think we are very important personality. We are serving Prabhupada. We are serving now Chaitanya Mahat. But a pure Vaishnava never think that way. A pure Vaishnava never think that way. Prabhupada one day shouting and speaking, why you are going to take trouble to get control over Guru Vaishnava? It is my duty, I am acting as Acharya. I am acting as Acharya, it is my duty. Why you are going to take trouble to get control over them? Unnecessarily. Prabhupada speaking, it is my advice that please try to look your fault. Try to find out your fault. Prabhupada speaking, it is my advice. It is my advice to you all. Please try to find your own fault. What is your fault and try to rectify it. Then and only then you can go ahead in the way of Bhagavad Bhajan. Otherwise, there is no question. There is no question, we cannot go up. When we are going to submit unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma in true sense, then actually, Dibhogyan supposed to develop, appear inside our heart. If our diksha is not perfect, in that case we cannot get Dibhogyan. Everybody cannot develop Dibhogyan, it depends. If our submission unto lotus feet of Sadguru is 100% perfect, if we are going to serve Guru Padma from heart, then the question of Dibhogyan coming. Otherwise, maybe somebody can claim, I have taken shelter 60 years back. But Prabhupada speaking, there is no symptom of Dibhogyan. How we can say that you are initiated? How we can say that you are initiated? If we are actually initiated, if we can develop Dibhogyan, immediately we can see everything, each and everything, in relation to Krishna. whenever we are developing Dibba Gyan, we can see that all everything in this world is the item of Krishna Seva, Prabhupada speaking. All items, everything. When we can get rid of second attention, Ditya Avinivesh, we can never become fearless. But Parikshit Maharaj, we see, is fearless by the mercy of Guru Padma. But we can never become fearless. We have different kind of fear. I am going to lose money. I am going to lose my position. Or different kind of, I am going to die maybe. I develop disease. Who can say I can die? This kind of second attention. When our attention is diverted from Guru Charan, then second attention develop, and that is called Maya. That is why we are always feeling fear all the time. Oh, so much fear all the time. But a pure Vishnu never can never fear about pratishtha, about money, position, nothing. It's not fear. Bhayam ditiya vinivishatahasat ishat apatasya viparya asriti tanmayaya avayatvam bhaktaikesham gurudevatatma. Full, if we feel full attraction unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma, full affinity, without Guru Padma we cannot live, without Vaishnava. At present, we don't know the tattva of Guru Vaishnava. That's why we cannot feel the value. We cannot feel, otherwise we can die without Vaishnava. If we feel the value, who is Vaishnava, who is Guru Vaishnava, then when Vaishnava disappear from this material world, then we are going to die, almost, you know, going to die. When the discussion took place between Raya Ramananda and Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu was, when the Harikatha was over, Mahaprabhu was putting so much question one by one. One question was that, Dukkha Madde Kon Dukkha Hai Guru Taro. We are feeling different kind of painful experience, but out of that, what is the topmost painful experience? Raya Mahasaya is saying, Vaishnav biraha bina dukcha nahi aar. Mahaprabhu asking, which is the topmost painful experience in this world? Suffering. Then Naimas are speaking that Vaishnava Biraha, when Vaishnava going away from us, leaving us alone here, we feel helpless. That kind of painful situation is, you cannot compare with anything. Though we know when Vaishnava going away from this material world, that is called, it is Brajo Vijay. It is Braja Vijay for Purusha. At the same time we are crying, at the same time we have some nice feeling that my Guru Pad Padma, I mean this Guru Vaishnava going to climb the eternal labor, is going away. Follow. This way, actually, when we are going to observe Abhirvaptiti, Tiravaptiti specially of Guru Vaishnava, we can get special kind of kippa. Somebody going to die, some relative or something, if we are going to cry, this become a tight bondage for us. But if we can cry for Guru Vaishnava, then we can get bumper success in our bhajan. Follow what I say. So we should see the whole world in relation to Krishna bhajan, Krishna seva item. Any woman, we should look that is Krishna Jasit. Only Kaminir Kam, Nahetobadham, Tahara Malik Keval Jadav. Who is Vaishnava? In this, in a verse, Prabhupada writing, Kaminir Kam, only Jadav, the jewel of Jadav destiny, Jadumani, Krishna. Bonded soul cannot enjoy impossible. Bonded soul cannot enjoy. They can try to enjoy, but this become a very, very painful experience for them, ultimately. Jadagre amritabhamam parinam vishamivaha. In Gita, Bhagavan says, which you are feeling very nice to enjoy in the beginning, starting. Ultimately, you are going to feel poison, poison, nothing. Follow. It's a very painful experience. You can. Our body, actually, our body, maybe woman and man, it matters little. Anybody, a jivatma going to take one body according to previous karma fall, any jivatma going to take anybody according to previous karma fall, man or woman, that's not a big matter. But this is matter. Your body is prakriti, matter. Your body is prakriti. You forget. You are not body. Your body is prakriti, matter, nature, prakriti devi. Woman body, man body, any body. All body is coming from matter. Kriti apatejmo bhoma, I mean, prakriti is a nature. Nature is inert object, we know, many time we hear, many time I explain, that then how possible that this material body, we think it is my body? And that is the question. Mahaprabhu giving example, one iron bar, if we put inside fire, that the iron bar can take the power of fire. Actually, iron bar cannot burn anything. A piece of iron bar, a piece of black iron bar, can never burn anything. It's not possible. But if I put that iron bar into fire, then automatically the quality of fire, the gunavali, going to enter into that iron piece. And Mahaprabhu giving example, as if when we are going to put iron piece inside fire, that the quality of fire going to be translated inside iron piece. And Mahaprabhu giving example, then that iron piece can act as a burning object. It can burn. Originally, iron piece cannot burn. But since it was there inside fire and the quality of fire already translated into iron piece, then now it is possible for that in iron piece to burn anything, what I like. Same example I am giving. Chidatma, your chinma, chit particle which is there inside your body, going to influence the whole body. And due to your previous karma fall, your, you know, material body and subtle body there, everything there. And after that, Atma, since Atma is there with his material body, that is why that whole body, I think it is my body, because the whole body can show the symptom of life. All limbs, all eyes, limbs, all everything can work because of the thing that Atma is there. Mahaprabhu giving example, when a drop of chandan, very costly sandal, malaya chandan, very costly sandal, one piece of sandal is 10,000, very costly. And that was used for Chandan Yatra. It was used at the time of, you know, Chandan Yatra by Madhavendra Puripad. That was very costly Chandan. if you can apply one drop of chandan tilak, you can try yourself. Mahaprabhu giving example. In Vedanta also this example given. One tilak if you make, it is prohibited. But chandan is rajasi, only Bhagavan can use chandan. Bhagavan, only Bhagavan has his right to use chandan. We cannot use. But still, suppose prasadi chandan, you are going to put a drop on your forehead, very, very, you know, round drop or, you know, square drop, any, or like tilak if you do, you can feel whole body cool, a soothing effect, cooling effect, like air condition. You can feel the tilak is there. Tilak is only there in your forehead, but the tilak can have a great effect on your whole body. Whole body. You can feel some cool. Your body can feel cool. Similarly, according to Vedanta, all different kind of examples there. Atma is there. And because of Atma is there inside body, that's why whole limbs and everything working. Like factory. You know, running, messing everything. But we should understand all our hand, legs, everything, material, all everything, all matter. But the matter in contact with this chetan particle, chit particle, going to have some effect. Just like the iron is feeling some effect due to iron, due to fire. So now you try to understand how foolish we are. How a man can enjoy woman, how a woman can enjoy a man, only one prakriti going to fight with one prakriti. Follow. One material body going to fight with one and another material body. This matter, nature. Actually, prakriti is inert, but we cannot feel. And a prakriti jagat, all enjoyment, everything is eternal. Their enjoyment is perfect enjoyment. This is not false enjoyment. Due to Maya, it is one kind of hypnotized. We are hypnotized by the spell of Maya. That's why we feel attraction for man, woman, everything this way we are doing. We cannot actually enjoy. That's why Prabhupada speaking, Kaminir kam nahitabadham tahara malik keval jadav. Only and only Jadukula Mani, the jewel of Jadukul destiny, Krishna, is a sole enjoyer. Any kind of enjoying mood in your life is one kind of trap. One kind of trap. All the time. Be careful. Now, Brihad Bhagavatam Rito Sanatana Goswami is so clever. Mahaprabhu speaking, Sanatana Samo Nahi Bigyati Bhuvani. In the three world, we cannot find such a personality like Sanatan who can think all everything in details. Very, very clearly. Follow what he said. Mahaprabhu speaking in this three world, there is nobody whom we can compare with Sanatan. Sanatan Samo Bigyan, a very knowledgeable personality. Knowledgeable meaning bhakti, bhakti man. Enjoying full kippah of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who can see past, present and for everything. That's why Sanatana Goswami was very, very careful. He was thinking how to inculcate bhakti inside others. How to arrange bhakti, how to install bhakti. Impossible. Because people don't like to get bhakti. They are acting. They are actually doing some kapat bhav, showing. Actually, bhakti nobody like to get, actual bhakti. If I am going to speak about mixed bhakti, then everybody can clap. Okay, Maharaj going to approve this one, that one. But if I speak about the Suddha bhakti, as shown by Rupa Goswami Pad, and as shown by Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then you become angry. I know. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, many of us, many among us, we have come in this devotional life, as at least we proclaim We claim that we have come in devotional life. Okay, as you, according to your own estimation, you are right. Who is going to stop you speaking like that? But point is that, Bhaktivinoda speaking, many among us coming in this devotional line, they are going to follow Ekadasi, Krishna Avirbhav Tithi, Janmashtami, Radhashtami, everything they are doing. They are going to do chant Anik also, because they claim that they have taken Diksha from some source. They claim that is right source, but we don't know. If right source, then why this kind of, you know, feeling coming? Either you are contaminated or your guru from the source you have taken Diksha from may be contaminated, who can say? We'll have to search out. Nityananda Babu, it is a duty of Nityananda, he can arrange our shelter. If you are 100% perfect, no duplicity, then be sure, Prabhupada speaking, it is the duty of Nityananda Balaram to arrange your shelter. Which shelter you can get, which guru? So Prabhupada speaking, according to karma phal, somebody getting karmi guru, somebody going to get Gyani Guru, Yogi Guru, but Bhakti Guru is very rare. Very, very rare. Now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, I know, most of us going to take shelter onto the lotus feet of Guru Padma, doing all ritualistic activities, all everything we are doing. We are also chanting Harinam also in bead bag. We are doing everything. Following everything, but we are not going to pay attention to the factor that where we are, when and how we are making mistake, when and how we are going to make some aparad unto the lotus feet of Bhakti Devi. That we are blind. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we are doing everything. We are doing dham parikram, we are doing everything. But we are not going to pay attention to the factor that when and how we are making aparad unto the lotus feet of Bhakti Devi. Every now and then we are going to make mistake and aparad unto the lotus feet of Bhakti Devi. In Kirtan, we know Dipogyan Hide Prakashito. Follow. What to speak of Dibya Gyan means Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. Dibya Gyan means Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. It's not so easy. Whereas Jamraji Maharaj was one among 12 Mahajan speaking. Yad Gyatra Amritam Ashnute. Guhyam Vishuddhyam Durvadhyam. Guhyam, very, very secrets of the secrets. Guhyam Vishuddhyam, very, very pure. No smell of any contamination. Guhyam, Vishuddham, Durvadhyam is very intricate. Our brain beyond human comprehension. Guhyam, Vishuddham, Durvadhyam, Yad Gyatta, Amritam Ashnuti. After having, you know, this knowledge of Dibya Gyan, I mean Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, we can enjoy Amrita. Jadgyata Amrita Mashnute. Mashnute means eat, drinking. Mashnute, eating. Amrita, yeah, drinking. Amrita means bhakti. Mai bhakti ribhutanam amrita taya kalpate. Krishna speaking to Gopigas. Mai bhakti ribhutanam amrita taya kalpate. Now we cannot understand where we are going to, when and how we are going to make mistake. Aparad unto the lotus feet of Bhakti Devi. When we are going to make a mistake, we don't know. We are doing everything, but we are less interested to identify. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, each and every moment we have to think over and again. We are making a mistake or not. Vaishnava aparad, nama aparad, dhamma aparad, you know, any kind of aparad we are doing, Bhakti Devi aparad, we are doing or not. Dibya Gyan everybody cannot get. Maybe 1,000 or 2,000 people, Jivatma has taken shelter onto a lotus feet of Madhav Goswami Maharaj. Srila Bhakti Nityananda Mahaprabhu says, who can say who is going to enjoy Divya Gyan? Who is going to say? Who can pass judgment in this bonded condition? Only the symptom can say. Only the symptom can say that that devotee, that Maharaj, that sadhu enjoying Divya Gyan. The symptom. But you have no idea about what all are the symptoms. Follow. Gujyam Vishuddham Durvadyam Jadgyata Amrishtam Ashnute, we can get. Naraji Maharaj speaking, but we are not getting Amrita, we are getting poison. We are doing bhakti, but all jealousy, you know, very, very, you know, envious attitude, not going away. That's been, we are developing aparadha. Like the great offense was done by Daksha, unto Lord Lotus feet of Vaishnavanang Jatha Sambhu. He wanted to apply his estimation. He wanted to apply his estimation power. Who is Shankar? He wanted to understand. But he don't know. Material man cannot see Guru Vaishnava. Vaishnava chinite nare devere shakti. Even those demigods, they cannot understand the mood of a pure Vaishnava. Then, how ordinary man can understand? Even demigods, they cannot understand. Vaishnava chinite nare devere shakti. Sir, follow, Maharaj say. This way, when and how we are developing aparadha unto Lord Svita, Harinam Prabhu, or Guru Vaishnava, we don't know. Dakha Prajapati, he was feeling proud of his own position. The rank given by Brahma. Lokpita Mahabrahma. That's why he is feeling very proud. Oh, I am having, you know, Sovarjundi, I am having controlling over this, you know. Now, I told already, it's one kind of bondage. That's why he was driven, you know, by this false ego. He was driven by this false ego, ultimately going to commit offense unto a lotus feet of Shankar Bhagavan, speaking all rubbish against Shankar. Vaishnavanam Jathasam. Now the point for why I am speaking this point, that when Dakha Yagya was done, everything was, you know, destroyed, then by the request of Brahma and all demigods, that Shankar Bhagavan was ready to go to that spot of Yagya to revive everything. And Dakha, he was also given life by Shankar Bhagavan. But his head was actually a goat head. But the original head was thrown in fire, burned up. So, there we can find in Bhagavatam, Dakha Prajapati going to pray. Dakha Prajapati going to pray some hymns. He is going to pray. So much thing he is speaking to pacify Shankar Bhagavan. Follow. But still, those who are writing comment to Vishwanath Chakravarti, they are speaking, though we find that Dakha Prajapati wanted to discover his own fault, wanted to take, you know, for excuse, he wanted to beg for pardon unto a lotus feet of Shankar Bhagavan, but still, Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, still, his mood of jealousy, still his mood of jealousy was not totally clear. The smell of jealousy was still there. That's why he took birth at Prachetas Daksha. Follow. Again he took birth as Prachetas Daksha. Follow. And there also, because he is habituated to commit aparadha unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, that's why he is going to commit aparadha unto the lotus feet of Naraji Bhagavan. He is going to curse. This way, This way, if we are really intelligent, if we understand our position, painful position, then surely we cannot do any aparadh. Parikshit Maharaj, 100% sure that I am going to die. And he was made fearless. He was totally fearless by the mercy of Gurudev Sukadev Goswami. So you are fearlessly you are hearing all Bhagavatam, and after hearing Bhagavatam, there is no question of death. Bhagavat is Amrita. After hearing Bhagavatam, there is no question of any death. That's why Parikshit Maharaj was feeling comfortable even when he is going to he knows that now I am going to leave body. That's why he can feel comfortable to speak Harikatha. He was feeling comfortable to speak Harikatha in front of Mother Uttara. Otherwise, who can speak? Parikshit Maharaj is not bonded soul, I already told. About Parikshit Maharaj, it is written three or four places in Bhagavatam, Esho Mahabhagavataha. Actually, Brahma Vidya to collect, to understand, to realize Brahma Vidya, to collect Brahma Vidya, Birochan and Indra, both. Indra Maharaj, king of heaven, and Birochan, the king of demons, and the son of Prahlad Maharaj. Both of them went to Devguru Brihaspati, who is a very, very learned, you know, Ved, Vedanta, everything. Both of them wanted to know Bhagavata, wanted to know Brahma Vigyan, Brahma Tattva. Both of them started learning Brahma Vidya in front of Brahmaji Maharaj. But after a long time, when Devguru Brihaspati going to ask some question to Indra Maharaj about Brahma Vidya, Indra Maharaj going to reply something, whereas Birochan going to speak just opposite. Now question, how possible? Same Gurudev, same time, both of them learning, but according to previous karmaphal, result totally different. At the bank of Ganga River, one coconut trees and one nim tree and another mango tree can grow. But finally we can find same water, same environment, same air. Finally, the neem tree going to give some bitter fruits, leaf and everything, whereas the fruits of mango tree is sweet. This way, according to Sanskar, it vary. In total, Vyad Bhagavatamrita, Sanatana Goswami Pad was so clever. He wanted to inculcate bhakti. He wanted to install bhakti inside our heart. With very, very carefully, he wanted to discuss all these things to clarify all complicacy regarding bhakti tattva. That day, I was discussing that Naradji was glorifying that king of South India, but that king was feeling very shy and speaking just opposite in front of Naradji Maharaj. Oh, Naradji, how you are going to glorify me, whereas I have nothing to be, glorified. So, Naradji, that king going to speak in front of Naradji Maharaj. Oh, Naradji Maharaj, better you can go to heaven. Heavenly planet, they are staying very safely. There is no disease, no sweat, no, nothing. They are also enjoying Amrita, everything. So I think, and also, very special case there with Purandar, I mean the king of the heaven. Mune, Vishishtas Tatrapi, Tesham Indra Purandaraha. Among those all demigods, Indra, position of Indra is very exclusive, very high. Because he is the ruler of heaven, Sargamatta Patal, everything. He can give punishment or give benediction to anybody, and also going to protect all this, you know, in this world. Vishtivhir Loko Jivanaha. He is going to give rain, arrange rain on proper time, so that crops can grow, and all human beings, they can, you know, harvest crop, and they can lead their life. And also, that king speaking is, that day I was speaking, Tilakashwarata Yasso Yuganam Eka Saptatim, I already told, 71 cycle of Chaturjug. Yuganam Eka Saptatim. You know. And also Indra going to enjoy reputation of doing the only man, the only, you know, personality. He is going to do 100 Ashwamedha Yajna. I already told. Then Pithu Maharaj wanted to break his record, but he was not allowed to do it. Indra Maharaj was feeling jealousy and making so much problem. So you see, Ja Ashwamedha Sate Napi Sarvabhaumasya Durlabha. It is very rare. And also, Hayo Uchchaisrava Yasso Gajo Vairavato Mahano Kamadhuko Gau Rupo Vanam Nandanancho Virajati. O receiver, try to give attention to this factor that Indra Maharaj enjoying, you know, very long life, you know, is going to rule the heavenly planet, and while the churning of the Kira ocean, during the time of churning of Kira ocean, that time the horse, special horse, Uchchasrava, and special elephant, Gaja Airavata, and Kamadhuko Gau, Gomata, Kamdhenu Gau, Kamduk, I already told how Jamadagni Muni, one Kamduk Gomata was there with Jamadagni Muni. Kartavijjava Arjun wanted to apply force and take away. I told already. So Kamduk, Kamdhenu mean, anything you are going to pray unto the lotus feet of Kamdhenu Gomata, she can give anything and everything. Also the tree there in the heaven, you can beg anything they can give. Follow. Kalpaturu. They can give everything. That's why Naraji Maharaj, you pay attention. The position of Indra Maharaj is very high. Unnecessarily you are going to appreciate me. He is going to speak. Now, according to comparative statement, that day I was speaking, first of all, our Sanatana Goswami Pad wanted to prove that it matters little whether he is coming from low caste or high caste, Brahmin or Kshatriya or Shudra, it matters little. According to the grade of bhakti, we are going to honor, follow. Kanishtha, Madhyam and Uttam Adhikari, according to bhakti. Not that he is from Brahmin, but so he is high, not that. That's why Sanatana Goswami Pad wanted to apply this rule. What is that rule? In Bhagavatam, we know, Viprat Disaraguna Jutat Aravinda Nava Padharavinda Vamukhat Sapachambarishtam. Bhagavatam. Even Brahman not going to follow in rules and regulation, a very low lifestyle, then if Viprat Disaraguna, if 12 qualities are also there, but devoid of bhakti, doing all rubbish. Viprat Disaraguna Yudha, or if all 12 qualities which is supposed to have in a Brahman, Viprat Disaraguna Yudhat Aravinda Nava, Padaravinda Vibhukhat, if he is averse to Krishna, I mean Vishnu, then Sapacham Barishtam, one very low caste, you know, is going to love Krishna, his position is very high. So, regarding bhakti, this much we can say, Guru Padma very often used to say this point, Kulin Panditer Varo Abhiman, Dinere Adhik Daya Karen Bhagavan. Guru Padma used to speak, who is very humble, Bhagavan going to give kipa to him. Dinere Adhik Daya Karen Bhagavan. Bhagavan going to give kipa to those who are very humble. Humbleness. Dinere Adhik Daya Karen Bhagavan. Kulin Panditer Abhiman. Kulin is from high family race. High family race, you know. Kulin Pandit is big. You know, Pandit, he claim at least that I am Pandit. They are very proud, always feeling, you know, proud mood. Always falsely go there. Janma isajya suto sivi redhamana madha pamano naiva arhati avidatum vai tamatkin tamakinchana gocharam. Kunti Devi speaking. Janma isajya suto si. Janma. He has taken birth in high family race. Janma isajya isajya appliances. Suto, very learned man. Janma suto sri, very good looking, handsome or beautiful. So they naturally bonded soul. They are going to develop false ego. They are always going to have false ego, that's why they can never get bhakti. Kunti Devi speaking, those are akinchan, niskinchan. Janmai sajya suto sivi redhamana madaha pramano. Their false ego can increase like fire by the touch of air. Fire coming in contact with air, then fire can grow and grow and grow. This is why Kunti Devi speaking, Janma Isajya Sruta Sivi Redo Mano Madhappa Mano. They can go on increasing their false ego. They can never understand you. In Gita class, Harikatha, I was discussing how we will have to enter the heart of Bhagavan. It's called Prema Bhakti. First of all, try to get ordinary bhakti. After that, you will have to, enter into prema bhakti. Otherwise, you cannot enter the heart of Bhagavan. Follow. Prema bhakti, very important. Sanatana Goswami Pada wanted to guide us very, very carefully. Because Sanatana Goswami know we are very sensitive to Maya. We don't like to do bhajan. So gradually Sanatana Goswami wanted to establish our Siddhanta Vichar. Follow. So comparatively we see the Brahman there at the bank of Allahabad, I mean Tribani Sangam, at the bank of three confluence of Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati. There the Brahman was showing some karma misra bhakti, he was doing. But the king of South India is far better. And the king also going to show some comparative statement. The position of Indra is very high. Those who are staying in Dimigo, those who are staying in heavenly planet, their position is very high. Unnecessarily, oh Muni, you are going to appreciate me. Actually, you go and check up, you check up what is their status? We are actually material man, any time can they, there is no certainty and death. There is no certainty. Our body is, you know, afflicted by three modes of nature. We are feeling sometimes, you know, sick, sometimes, you know, tired, so much thing, but there are nothing there. Also, they are enjoying Amrita, so much facility there. Why not you go and appreciate Indra Maharaj? And also, that king speaking, Parijata dayo yatro vartante kamapura kaha. Parijat bhikkhu, the tree Parijat. Follow, Parijat. Parijata dayo yatro vartante kamapura kaha. The Parijat Briksha is there. If we can pray anything, they can fulfill our desire. A kama rupa dhara, kalpa dhruma, kalpo latanitaha, that Nandan Kanan, heavenly garden, there Parijat Briksha is there, Parijat Briksha is there. Parijat adi, Parijat adi, etc. Kalpa bhikkhu, kam rupo dharo, kalpa latha, itadi, all decorated there in the garden. Heavenly garden, Nandan Kanan. What to speak more? What you can speak more? Nandan Kanan yate ekti puspadhara, you know, what to speak more? One flower, if we can collect from that Nandan Kanan, we can get all facility, all enjoyment, like git, song, musical instrument playing, dancing, we can get cloth, we can get all ornament, we can get different kind of, you know, chatur vidosi bhagavat prasada, we can get all. Sweet, bitter, and a salty thing, all different kind of food item. To eat, we can get anything. No, no, follow. All different kind of desire, they can fulfill those trees. So what to speak more? They have so much opulence there in heaven. And you are going to glorify me? So heavenly, you know, in the heavenly planet there in heaven, Indra is a king of all, you know. Indra. So, also one point is that we cannot speak the luck of Indra. We cannot speak the luck, very, very highly lucky Indra. Because all the time Bhagavan Vishnu in the form of Vamandev, and he is taking birth as a younger brother of Indra Maharaj. He is going to give honor to Indra as the elder brother. All is going to follow. Is going to follow Indra Maharaj as the elder brother. And also going to save Indra Maharaj from different kind of dangers. Danger? Just now he told they are very peaceful and they are feeling enjoying. No, no. That is why comparative statement. The South Indian king speak that way. But we can now prove that the heavenly plan is most unstable. All the appliances enjoying, and Indra Maharaj going to enjoy, all unstable, nothing stability there. We're going to prove it. First of all, the South Indian king going to establish his tatha in front of Indra. Indra going to reach heaven and going to glorify. We can come to this point, not now. Here actually the South Indian king speaking from different kind of dangerous situation. Vamandev Maharaj Vishnu going to save Indra and going to give enjoyment, give assurance to Indra Dev. And also different those who are inhabitants of this heavenly planet, they are always going to worship, worship Vishnu Bhagavan, I mean Vamandev. What to speak more? What to speak more? You know more than me. It is one kind of audacity. It is one kind of audacity that I am going to, you know, speak all this tattva. But you know it very well, more than me. What is the, you know, what is the lifestyle? What is the lifestyle there in the heaven? And how Indra are enjoying? Follow what I say. Then Naradji Maharaj immediately took his initiative to reach heaven. Parikshit Maharaj speaking to mother, Prashasso Twam Maharajan Sargato Muni Raikhyato Rajamanam Sabhamadhe Vishnum Devaganair Britam. After hearing so much thing about the heavenly planet and about Indra Maharaj, Naradji Maharaj going to glorify the king, South Indian king, and took his initiative to reach heaven. He started and going to enter the assembly where Devasava. There was an assembly, very, very nice assembly there, and all demigods there, sitting there. And they are also going to watch the lotus feet of Vishnu, I mean Bamandev Maharaj climbing on the, riding on Garuda Bhagavan, who is the Prakash of Anantadev. And all those demigods, they are going to make garland by the help of different fruits, different kind of flowers collected from Nandan Kanan. A Parijat Bhiksha, you know, follow. Kamadhuk Bhiksha, they are going to collect flowers, different kind of, you know, very, very nice smell and color. They are going to make, you know, garland to offer. They are going to apply some, you know, chandan and everything in the body of Bhagavan to satisfy him. Going to give, offer new clothes and everything. With Amrita, everything else, they are going to orsi. And all those Maharshi, Brihaspati and other, you know, other Maharshi, they are going to glorify Bhagavan. So what is written? Parikshit Maharaj speaking, Prashasso Twam Maharajan Sargato Muni Raikhyato Rajamanam Sabhamadhe Vishnum Deva Ganair Britam Vichitra Kalpa Druma Pushpa Mala Bilepa Bhushavasana Mrita Advai Vichitra Kalpa Druma Pushpa Mala Bilepa Bhushavasana Mrita Advai Samarchitam Dibbotaro Pocharai Sukhopavishtam Garuda Sapishti. I already explained. And Brihaspati Pravitibhi. Brihaspati and other Muni rishis, Brihaspati Muni and all other rishis, they are going to glorify. Brihaspati Pravitibhi. Stuyamanam Maharshibhi. All Maharshi they are going to glorify. Lallamanam Aditya. Mother Aditi is the mother of all demigods. Lallamanam Aditva Tano Harsayantam Priyoktivi. Aditima going to love his son, her son, and going to love, and also Bamandev Bhagavan going to pass some nice, very soft remark, going to pass different kind of soft remark to make them happy. Follow what I say. Or Dibbo Vidya Dharo Gandharva Apsaro Siddho Vidya Dharo Gandharva Apsaro Apsaro Apsaror Vividhai Stavai Jaya Sabdai Baddha Gita Nitrescha Paritoshitam. Follow. Siddho Vidyadhara Gandharva Apsaror Vividaistavi. Siddho Vidyadhara Gandharva All they are going to glorify Bhagavan. They are speaking Jai Vamandev Maharaj, Jai Bhagavan Vishnu ki Jai ho. Jai Sabdai, Baddha Sabdai, they are made, playing on musical instrument. And Jai Sabdai, Baddha Gita Nitvaischa. They are going to show their art and, you know, they are dancing and singing in front of Bhagavan to give full satisfaction to Bhagavan. Follow. This way, they are speaking all Jai, Jai, Bhagavan, Jai Ho, Jai Ho, they are speaking. Now, Sakraya, Sakraya, Abhayam, Uchokta, Daityebhyo, Dadatam, Diram. And Vamandev Maharaj, Bhagavan Vishnu, going to give assurance that no, hey Rajan, don't fear, I am there, I am going to save you. Let all demons attack, I am there, you don't fear. That's why Vamandev Maharaj, Bhagavan Vishnu going to give assurance to Indra Maharaj, assurance so that he cannot feel, fear. Sakraya, 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 Abhayam, Uccho, Sakraya, Abhayam, Uchokta, Daityebhyo, Dadatam, Diram, and Kirtva Arpanam, Tambulam, Charvantam, Lilaya Hirtam. Kirti, the Shakti of Vamandev Maharaj, Vamandev Bhagavan, Kirtva Arpamanam, Tambulam, Charvantam, Lilaya Hirtam. Bhagavan, sitting, riding on Garuda Bhagavan, everybody glorifying, worshipping everything. Now, in the meantime, the Shakti of Vamandev Maharaj, his name is, Kirti, Kirtima, is the Shakti of Bhagavan. She is going to offer Tambul, bitter leaf, tasteful bitter leaf, to Vamandev Maharaj, and Vamandev Maharaj going to collect all this, beetle leaf, everything for him, no problem. Now we are going to see what is the Naraji Maharaj reached there. And now going to watch everything, really so. Naraji Maharaj speaking, really so. What I heard from that South Indian king, really so. Everything nice here, all enjoyment there, going on. Sakru, the Indra Maharaj sitting beside in a separate throne, singhasan, Devaraj Indra sitting beside Bhagavan and all umbrella, or danda, chamar, chamar, the fan made up of charmigai, special, we are going to blow air, going to, do arati. Narahari adi kori chamar udulaire, that chamar. So, the followers of Indra Maharaj going to serve Indra Maharaj with chamar, chatra, the white umbrella, everything, and going to glorify Indra and his luck. And also, Indra Maharaj going to express gratitude Also, Indra Maharaj is going to express gratitude unto the lotus feet of Bhavandev Maharaj for the kind of benefit he is going to get from his younger brother Bhavandev. Follow. Indra Maharaj is going to express his gratitude for the kind of benefit he is going to get and the kind of kripa he is going to receive from Bhavandev Maharaj, and going to shed tears. It is Anandasru. Because of excellent thrill, Indra Maharaj going to shed tears. Sakruñcatasya Mahatmam Kirtayantam Muhurmuhur Swasmin Kritopukarangscha Varnayantam Mahamuda Asahasra Nayanair Rashudhara Varsantam Asane Shiye Sahasra Nayanair Asrudhara Varsantam Asane Shiye Nishannam Tat Parshe Rajantam Sha Vibhutivi. All different kind of affluence going to serve Indra Maharaj sitting beside Bhavandev Bhagavan, and is going to express gratitude and is going to think about causeless mercy expressed by Bhavandev Maharaj for him. So he is going to express, he is going to shed tears due to enjoyment. And Indra, has thousands of eyes, Sahasra Lochan. The name of Indra is Sahasra Lochan. Sahasra means? Thousand Lochan. Sahasra Lochan. There is one big history background. I don't like to speak now. No time. So you see, this way, Naraji Maharaj reached there. Naraji Maharaj wanted to talk with, Indra Maharaj. He wanted to glorify Indra, but he was waiting because the situation was, gravity of the situation was very high, very, sophisticated. So he was waiting for some time. Now, actually, he is searching time when can speak with Indra Maharaj. He is searching the time. Follow what I say. Atho Vishnum Nijavase Gacchantam Anugammatam Savayam Agatam Sakram Asasso Vachanarada. Follow. Then gradually everything was over. Then Bhavandev Maharaj, Vishnu Bhagavan, going to his room from this assembly. At the same time, Indra Maharaj also going behind. It's an honor to be shown. Atho Vishnum Nijavase. Nijavase means his nijar, his own personal abode. Atho Vishnum Nijavase. Gacchantam Anugammatam. Anugammaman. Also, Indra Maharaj following Bhavandev to give honor, and Naraji Maharaj also following because there is the scope to get bhakti. And after that, come back. Follow. Anantar Vishnu, when going to his home, going to house, own home, then Devaraj Indra going to follow for some time to give honor. Then when Devaraj Indra come back to the assembly again, then Naraji Maharaj going to bless from heart and started giving congratulation, Abhinandan, and going to glorify, "You are the great. Now in front of my eyes I see everything. What a great affluence you have. Really, you are lucky. You are very lucky. now going to sleep. Now gradually we can break. First of all, it is a humble attitude of Guru Vaishnava. Try to understand. It is the humble attitude of Guru Vaishnava. They always going to glorify others. They never find any quality in themselves. That is a vital point. Try to understand. To establish this point, how humble a devotee is, gradual promotional procedure we can see. All devotees, they think, I am nothing. Who am I? You see, he is great devotee. This way. And those who are non-devotee, those who are committing aparad, they are nobody, you know, all my godbrothers, they are useless. They are not even human beings. I am only preacher. They speak. That's when bhakti is not there, 100%. If bhakti is there, bhakti can give you humbleness. Humbleness can give you nectar. Nectar can give you satisfaction. Nectar can give you, satisfaction. You know, follow what I say. Saturation point. Then you have no scope to speak that way. A true preacher, a genuine preacher, can never speak that way. What I have done? I have done nothing. They can speak that way. So, what? This way, Naraji Maharaj now, Atho Vishnum Nijavase Gacchantam Anugammatam Savayam Agatam Sakrum Asasso Vacho Narada. Say, Narad started glorifying Indra Maharaj. Naraji Maharaj speaking, Kritanu Kampita Stvam Yat Surja Channo Jamadayuhu Tavagyakarinaha Sarve Lokopalaha Pare Kimu Muneo Ashmadrisho Basha Sruta Yoho Stvam Stubantihi Jagadisho Taya Yastvam Dharma Phalo Pradaha. Indama, now Naraji Maharaj speaking, Hey Devraj, now I see your status and position. Oh, Naraji Maharaj, you are really lucky. You are enjoying the kippa of Vishnu Bhagavan, Anukampito. You are really going to enjoy a kippa of Bhagavan Vishnu, Vamandev. Because all sun god, moon god, Yamaraja, all different kind of Lokpala, those who are taking charge of different ministry, like water source, air source, Vabandev, you know, Varundev, they are going to follow your order. They are all going to follow you, come on, they are going to follow your order. How lucky you are. And all Basu, Ashtabasu, all, they are going to follow your order. They are going to carry out your order. What to speak more? A Muni, like me, also under your control. Also, a Muni like me is also under your control. Whenever you call me, I am bound to come. And all Suti, you can go through Veda, different clause of Veda you can find. Now, in these topics, I must clarify this point. Shruti means Veda. Though we know from Gita, from Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan speaking himself, Vedasya sarve rameva vidyo. After reading whole Veda, Vedanta, if you cannot understand, you cannot know me, then your reading Vedas all useless. Then your reading Vedas is only taking trouble. You are going to say, you don't understand. It is useless. Now point is that, Naraji Maharaj speaking, that in Veda, in different parts, we can find the Veda going to glorify Indra and Namaha, they are going to glorify Indra. follow. In Veda, in different part, we can find some point where Veda is going to glorify Indra. Try to understand. I like to clarify this point in front of you. Veda, total Veda, in 6th canto already written, according to the grade, according to the standard of different and Jivatma, different kind of, you know, Veda going to guide different way. According to their test, they can at least move, they can at least move forward. A little bit, maybe. But at least they can move forward. Mother going to show some sweet bone. The boy don't like to take that bitter medicine. Mother going to show, I can give this, you know, sweet ball if you take this medicine. No, I cannot. I can give you the sweet. Okay, then you give first. No, first of all, you take this medicine. Then I can give. Now my question is odd that mother don't like to give sweet to the son and the boy. Or mother don't like to put the son in trouble with this bitter medicine. The only objective, the only purpose is that to make the boy free from any disease. He is applying medicine. This way, all Vedas, according to the standard of divine Jivatma, going to sow different. Oh, you like to get, you have no children. Oh, really? You do this yajna, putreshtu yajna. Oh, you like to get samajna. You do a samaj yajna. This different kind of yajna, different kind of ritualistic activities given. But actually, in true sense, those were not at all ritualistic activities. Because Naraji Maharaj is going to speak clearly. Je punya se punya se sukher dham naloyo tarna. Don't speak about the question of punna, pious activities. Our Narottama Thakur speaking, don't try to speak about pious activities. It's more dangerous. Oh, really? Yes. Due to pious activities, you'll have to go to higher upper planet, then again you have to come down, fall down here. Maybe you can express some false ego because you are now reaching higher planet. Humbleness cannot come either way. Follow what I say. It's more dangerous. So Narottama Thakur speaking, punno se sukhe dham naloyo tarna. Punno is a source of pious activities. See, if we do pious activities, we are less interested about pious activities or sinful activities. Both bondage for us. Follow. We are less interested about pious activities or sinful activities because both bondage for us. We need bhakti. Bhakti is neutral. We like to do bhakti. We are less interested about that. So you see, there's a big problem. It's bondage for us. So in different Vedas, you can go through different Vedas, Riksam, Joju, Atharva, different branches there, countless branches. You can go, sometime you can find some sloka where you can feel, oh, well, here we see this sloka going to glorify Indra. But be sure, don't be foolish. Veda going to guide common people. And ultimately, Bhagavan speaking, Vedaischa Sarave Rahameva Vidya. Ultimately, after reading all Vedas, if you cannot come to the conclusion that Bhagavan is all in all, Ishvaraha Paramakrishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarvakaranuka. If you cannot understand this point, then your reading Veda all useless. So sometime you can find the name of Indra, sometime you can find the name of Varuna, sometime you can find the name of, you know, Pavandev. It's quite natural, Agni. Om Agnim Ile Purohitam. This kind of different slokas from Veda we can find. But all, if you go through Veda under the guidance of very, very clever sadhu, follow, then you can understand. Well, here the glorification of Indra is given, but it is all the topics is regarding Karmakanda. The Karmakanda chapter of Veda, sometime going to deal with Indra, sometime going to deal with Varuna, sometime going to deal with Pavandev. So don't be foolish. It's all Karmakanda. It's for ordinary man, not for you. Because you have taken resolution to do pure bhakti, so you'll have to do what you promise. So we see, now here we find, Naraji Maharaj speaking very casually. Naraji Maharaj going to glorify is quite natural. A devotee always going to glorify others. I am nothing, and in front of you I am nothing. Kritanakampita stvam yat yat. Follow, Naraji Maharaj speaking. Kritanakampita stvam yat suryo chandro yamadayoho tabagyakarinaha sarve lokopalaha pare kimu munayo asmadrisho basha srutayoho stvam stuvantihi jagatishataya yastam dharma dharma phala pradaha. Dharma dharma, according to their activities, jivas, you are going to give result. And all Vedas, Shruti, are going to glorify you. This way, Naraji Maharaj started glorifying Indra Maharaj. Glorifying Indra Maharaj this way. Aho, Narayana Bhrata Kanyana Yasso Sahodaraha. Narayan himself coming in the form of younger brother. Oh, same mother. Aho. Aho, Narayana Bhrata Kanyana Yasso Sahodaraha. He is a younger brother. Coming in the womb of same mother. Aditi. Asadharmam manayano yasso vidadhati adaram sada. Sadharman, you are going to follow sadharma, your own dharma principle, everything. Very punctually, you are going to do perfectly. You are going to enjoy this kind of honor, because Vishnu is your younger brother. He is going to give you the honor of your elder brother. Very, 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 very high honor you are getting. And that Bhagavan also, Vishnu Bhagavan, to follow sadharma, going to guide you, going to help you. Going to honor you, going to give you inspiration all the time. Follow what I say. Those Veda sometimes going to glorify. If somebody cannot understand the reason, then they can be in confusion. They must understand those Karmakanda chapters, those are Karmakanda branches, where sometime Veda going to glorify Indra, but sometime going to glorify Varundev, some going to Pavandev, But that doesn't mean they are all in all. Sometime Veda going to glorify Indra in such a way, you can go mad. Oh Maharaj, this way going to, just like Supreme Lord? Yes. Sometime going to glorify that way, but then you should understand that if Indra Maharaj has no separate existence, like Bhagavan speaking in Gita, whatever worship common people going to do of any demigods, ultimately they are going to worship me. But, Abhidhi Purvakam, it is not the rules. follow. It is not the rules. They are going to whenever they are going to worship any demigods, they are finally going to worship me. Follow what I say. So all, you know, Vaibhav Prakash, Bhagavan actually, so when sometime in Veda written that, then time you can feel Indra and Bhagavan Supreme Lord, you know, almost, you know, when you can feel that Indra has no separate existence, then Bhagavan, so all the honor actually for Bhagavan. Apparently it is for Indra. Follow. When Indra going to feel, I am non-different from Bhagavan, then and only then, Vaishnavi Pratishtha can come. Indra going to take separate Pratishtha, it is Vishtha, stool. When Indra going to arrange personal Pratishtha for him, and fighting with, all demons, is called, not Vaishnavi Pratishtha. Follow what I say. Try to understand. Now, gradually, we can go on describing, you know. So, Sanatana Goswami, very clever, gradually wanted to give, show us a comparative statement and going to guide us very secretly because we don't like to do bhajan. So, Sanatana Goswami like to engage us in bhajan through the discussion of Brihadagama Bhagavatamrita, gradually, went to go up. Parikshit Maharaj speaking to his mother, oh mother, ittham indrasya saubhagya vaibhavam kirtayan muhu. This way, Indra Maharaj going to glorify the luck of Indra and going to play musical instrument and going to dance even. Ittham indrasya saubhagya vaibhavam kirtayan muhu. Going to glorify about Indra very, very repeatedly. Devarsir Badayan Vinam Slagamano Nanatatam. They started dancing even. Tato, after that, Tato Abhivaddo, going to give congratulation to Indra. Tato Abhivaddo Devarsim Ubachendra Sanoir Riya. Tato Abhivaddo Devarsim Ubachendra Sanoir Riya. Then after Naraji Maharaj going and glorifying, dance and singing, oh Indra, you are lucky. Who can enjoy this kind of luck that, you know, Bhagavan Vishnu coming and going to give you the honor of elder brother and going to take the chair of younger brother all the time? Going to get control under your control because of affection you have for your brother? When Parikshit Maharaj speaking that Indra and that Naraji Maharaj glorifying this way, at the same time Indra Maharaj going to feel sigh. Oh my God, this great Rishiva Devarsi Indra going to glorify me? What is my position? Oh my God. Tato Abhivaddo, going to give congratulation, going to pay dandavat, everything. Devarsim Ubacha Chandra. Sanai Riya, out of very, in a sighful mood, out of very sighful mood, Indra Maharaj going to speak in front of Naraji Maharaj. Tato Abhivaddha Devarsin Ubachendraha Sanai Riya Bho Gandharva Kalavigyaha Ho Gandharva Kalavigyo King Mam Upahasanasi. Why you are going to, you know, make joke with me? Bho Gandharva Kalavigyo. You are, you know, great Pandit at the same time. You have all different arts and culture. They are Gandharva. You are great leader. Ho Gandharva Kalavigyo. You have great experience about different kind of dancing, singing, everything. Gandharva Kalavigyo, dancing, singing, you know, playing music, everything. Gandharva Kalavigyo. What? What? You like to joke with me? Hey receiver, you are going to joke with me? Eh? Eh? What do you? Tato abhivaddo devarsim ubachendraha sanairya bhogandharva kalavigyo king mam upahasannasi. You are going to make joke with me? You are going to laugh? You know, it's one kind of laughing stroke. You are going to glorify me? Oh my God! Ah, now I am going to clarify you that most unstable position. I have no Vaishnavi position, nothing. Why my situation is very bad. Now I am going to clarify. You are going to glorify me? You see, you are speaking. I have so much affluence. What much affluence you have? Eh? All material offences. Eh? This way, Indra Maharaj, out of his humble attitude, going to break, you know, going to request Naraji Maharaj, please don't do that, because it is one kind of laughing stock. Nobody should glorify me this way. No. What I can do? The sloka you can remember I started with in the first. It is the glorification of Srimad Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran. It is the glorification of Srimad Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran from Padma Puran. Nacha indrasya sukham kinchinna sukham chakravartina sukham asti viraktasya muner ekant jivina. Nacha indrasya. No! Indra is not at all happy. No! What do you say? Yes. Indra is not at all happy. Nacha indrasya sukham kinchinna sukham chakravartina. Those who are enjoying big sovereignty on this earth, that big, big king, they are also not happy. Happy mean? Transcendental happiness is not there. They are not happy. Because now they are happy, maybe tomorrow they can start cackling. Yesterday, you saw Indra is out of his chair. Eh? He was displaced from his position. Now you find he come back again. Follow what I say. The reason for why Vamandev Maharaj took birth, eh? There in the womb of Ditima. In the womb of Ditima, you know it very well. Why Vamandev Maharaj came in the womb of Kashyap Muni and Diti Maharaj? Diti. Follow. Coming in the womb of Diti, because Diti Maharaj, Diti Ma, the mother of all demigods, Diti Ma, she was feeling very sorry because his sons, Indra and all, you know, his sons, they are displaced from this heavenly planet. They are now like beggar, running here and there, no stability. This is the situation. So she took permission from Kashyap Muni to observe one vow, brata. And that brata, that vow was, you know, payabrata, milk brata, payabrata. He was asking for advice. Then Kashyap Muni going to advise him, well, you can observe payabrata very perfectly, then Bhagavan can become very satisfied with you, can, you know, give benediction to you, because there is no other way. Follow what I say. Then after that, payabrata, he was doing payabrata, and 12 days payabrata was so perfect. 12 days duration, the duration of that vow, brata, was only 12 days. But it was so perfect, that Bhagavan Vishnu became very happy and knowing very well that Diti Ma not going to show pure bhakti. Diti Ma going to follow this Payabrata with some intention, with some secret desire. What is that desire? Oh, so that my sons, you know, Indra and everybody, they can come back to their heavenly planet, they can get their, you know, chair, everything. They are now, you know, running here and there like mad. That's why Ditima crying. So she wanted to observe this vrata to get some benediction. It is not pure mood. Be careful. Whole world, Abrahma Bhuvana Loka, or Brahma, from right from Brahma up to end, all have some desire. Follow. They are cyclic order, they are moving around this, you know, 14 worlds. Sometime king, sometime servant, sometime woman, sometime insect, sometime tiger, sometime snake. This way they are rotating. In course of their traveling through these 14 worlds, they are bound to take different kind of body. Come on, this human body you get, don't try to waste. Follow what I say. Prabhupada always going to advise us, don't try to misuse this human life. Human body is most rare. Don't try to misuse it with different kind of, you know, desire and this, that fulfillment. No! This body, human body, is not meant for this purpose. It's only for Hari Bhajan. You forget it. That's why different kind of problem coming to put you in trouble. Follow what I say. So Diti Ma going to observe this 12 days Vrata. It is so perfect that the last day Bhagavan Vishnu appear in the Jagya and going to offer Diti Ma, oh mother, I know the reason for why you call me. He wanted to observe this Vrata. Well, I am going to fulfill your heart. What do you need? I like to see all my sons, and you know, they can come back to heaven. They are like beggar. I cannot bear. Well, okay. Okay. But somehow I have to arrange it. Not so easy. So Bamande Maharaj came in dream of Kasab Muni. He, Vishnu Bhagavan, going to give some instruction. Well, I am going to take birth from your womb. So we see Bamande Maharaj ki jai. Bamande Maharaj going to take birth as a small boy from the womb of, you know, Diti Ma, as a son of Kasap Muni. Follow. There is so much, you know, description there how the sanskar was done, how nice sanskar for me, you know, sanskar was done at the time. And after that, Batuk Brahman, wanted to reach the spot of Bhrigukacha. Bhrigukacha. Bhrigukacha means one place. At the bank of that Narmada, Bhrigukacha. Very important place. There Bali Maharaj going to arrange all this jagya. And now Bamanji Maharaj taking birth, very nice, very clever, taking birth, and after that putting on that karam, you know, wooden chapel, taking one kamandul and danda, one umbrella, everything. Oh, he was fully decorated. Different kind of, you know, donation was Bhagavati Ma giving the pot for bhiksha, Saraswati giving akshamala. Follow what I say. Different kind of, you know, donation, you know, presentation was given. And, you know, now Bamandev Maharaj straightway going, you know, very, very smartly going to the spot of Bhrigukacha, the spot where the jagya going, where the jagya going on. Follow. You know, Bali Maharaj doing jagya. There the Bhavan coming, his body effulgence. Like the case you can remember. When Mahaprabhu was requested by Prakasananda, why you are sitting here, this, you know, dirty place? Why not you come here? you are very important. Then Bhagavan Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sitting in this in a very dirty place to show that I am nothing in front of you. Very humble attitude. Humble attitude is so powerful that if you apply this humble attitude, even Bhagavan can come to give response to you. But you think humble attitude means is useless. Oh, those who are very weak, they are humble. No! No! Follow, somebody thinking, oh, humbleness man is very weak. Everybody can kick, you know. Oh, we should have some false ego, like manpower, money power, everything. Not that. Humble attitude is very powerful. Dainena kriyatam sakalam jagat. Humble attitude if you have, and if you are really Pandit and Bhakta, like Mahaprabhu, I can discuss maybe after some day, I can discuss this point. What is the formula of Mahaprabhu? To conquer the heart of all devotees. You know, we will have to follow the same. We cannot follow because they have some jealousy inside our heart. It's very dangerous. It is one kind of chronic disease. Follow what I say. Then after that, Bamanji Maharaj coming in the form of a son of Ditima and the son of, you know, Kassap Rishi, and going in front of Bali Maharaj, and the body falls. Mahaprabhu, when he was in Prakasananda, when requesting, Mahaprabhu, after sitting in the dirty place, going to express so much high effulgence of the body that it looks like at a time thousands of sun rising in the sky, but still some soothing feeling, not burning feeling. That is a specialty. So all Prakasananda, everything, they that time they feeling as if, you know, it's very, oh my God, who is he? Similar way, Babaji Maharaj going to enter the Jagya spot of Bali Maharaj. At the same time, from distant place, everything say, oh, a sun god coming. So, power of the body. As body effulgence. When Babaji Maharaj coming gradually in the front of the Jagya place, then this, oh, it's Batuk Baman. It's Bamandev Maharaj. Oh, then Bali Maharaj stand up, all, you know, those who are, you know, those who are arranging Jagya or Rishi Man, they all stand up to pay honor. And Bali Maharaj speaking, the reason for why you are coming, let me know. I like to know the reason for why you, O Brahman Dayat, O the son of Brahman, I like to know. Your coming here can never go in vain. Your coming here and the Jagya spot can never go in vain. Because I am Bali Maharaj, you know. I can give anything. What do you need? Eh? What do you need? I can give anything. What do you want? I can give everything and anything. I am the king, you know. Sargamata Pata. I am the king. So you can ask anything. Follow. This way, the reason I am speaking, how Bali Maharaj was so much compassionate for Indra. Even for Indra, he was, you know, he was bound to do some such behavior with Bali Maharaj, which is apparently not good. Follow what I say. Bali Maharaj speaking, I can give you donation, anything, what you want. And you, if you want anything, I can give you anything, what you want. You know, anything I can give. Any continent, and if you want any continent, I can give you. Or any barsha, I can give you. Whatever you want. Or a horse, elephant, all different offenses, unending offenses I can give you. You are ready to take. But I like to know the reason for why. Yes, actually I am come bhiksha. I am coming here to beg bhiksha from you. But you will have to give bhiksha according to my desire. Not fancifully. Well, what you do? What you need? I am actually Brahman. So, I am always saturated. So I am not feeling any dissatisfaction inside heart. So what I want, you have to give. What do you want? I want to get the 3 steps of land. Huh? You are Bhutukban, very short height. Your leg is very short. 3 steps of land. What you can do? This is very small. You cannot even sit properly. Well, you are to give it. If you cannot give, I can go. Well, I can give you. Om. When I promise, I can give you. When Bali Maharaj is going to promise, in the meantime, Shukracharya, the Acharya of Asura, is going to point out, Esho Vishnu Rabbayaha. He is Vishnu. He is coming to cheat you. Bali Maharaj, be careful. He is coming to cheat you. Bali Maharaj is not going to pay any attention to the instruction of his Gurudev. Because if at all is Vishnu, then I am very lucky. Vishnu, for infinite period, we cannot see the lotus feet of Vishnu. Now I am so lucky, the Vishnu himself coming here to give darshan and to give kippa. Why should I avoid Vishnu? He is going to disobey the instruction of his Gurudev. That is the highness of Bali Maharaj. Bali Maharaj is going to get the teachings of Prahlad Maharaj. Why we respect Bali Maharaj? Why we respect Bali Maharaj? Because Bali Maharaj going to get the teachings of Prahlad Maharaj. That's why Bali Maharaj is also one of the 12 Mahajan. Swayambhur Narada Sambhu Kumar Kapilo Manu Prahlad Vishma Janako Balir Bayasakir Bayam. Balir Bayasakir Bayam. So Bali Maharaj is so lucky. Though he is Asura, he is the grandson of Prahlad Maharaj, but his Gurudev is not Shukracharya. Apparently you find that the Guru is Shukracharya. How he can get Dibya Gyan? Actually, Bali Maharaj in material life going to follow this. And for spiritual improvement, always going to follow the instruction of Prahlad Maharaj, the God and the Guru. The great devotee of Vishnu. So we can see the excellency of Bali Maharaj. Otherwise, who is going to worship Bali Maharaj? Every yajna, Vaishnav yajna, any yajna, whatever yajna we are doing, we are going to arrange one share. Any yajna, any time we are doing Vaishnav yajna, anything, we are going to reserve one, you are going to reserve one share of Bali Maharaj. We are going to arrange the share of Bali Maharaj, the Adas Mahajan. We are going to offer Boga. Follow what I say. Very important. So Bali Maharaj is not, you know, maybe he has taken birth, but his conception is totally regulated by Bhakti, you know, Prahlad Maharaj. He is following that Prahlad Maharaj, the great. That's why we honor him. He is also going to get the chair of one Mahajan. We are going to honor. But His Excellency is there. His Excellency wanted to prove that it matters little whether my Gurudev speaking or lie. Anyway, Vishnu coming, what I put commitment, my commitment is commitment. I promise that I can give to you. Well, I can give you. I can give you. So this way, you know, I wanted to conclude this point that why Indra Maharaj shedding tears with, you know, in love, loveful mood, that it is Bali Maharaj, my younger brother. He took trouble to go to Yajna and wanted to play some drama to take all, you know, my heavenly planet for me. It's just causeless mercy. They think that way. But if somebody is going to give a heavenly planet to me, I can throw. But it's Indra Maharaj thinking that way. Why we can, we don't want that kind of, it's one kind of bondage. Anyway, so we can discuss this point tomorrow and clearly, and going to clarify that Indra, though Naraji Maharaj going to glorify, but still Indra Maharaj going to give some reply very humbly, so that he can prove, hey Naraji Maharaj, why you are glorifying me? all unstable here in heavenly planet. You don't know what was the situation when Bali Maharaj attracted me in the heaven. I was bound to fly, go away. Even I couldn't take my wife with me. So poor situation. Now you are going to glorify me. I can gradually try to explain what Sanatan Goswami Pad wanted to speak. All your blessing I need. So today I'll have to stop here. Sorry, we'll have to stop here. Tomorrow we can discuss all in details. And want to establish what is bhakti, what is humble attitude, and how Naraji Maharaj wanted to speak, and how Indra Maharaj wanted to, you know, gradually nullify, wanted to avoid. No, you cannot glorify me. Na cha indrasya sukham kinchinna sukham chakravartinah sukham asti viraktasya mune rekant jivinah. Na cha indrasya sukham kinchinna sukham chakravartinah sukham asti viraktasya mune rekant jivinah. Vancha kalpatu rusikipa sindhu bevacha patitanam pavana bhavishna vyo namah.